Portugal securing their spot yesterday by making it into this round.
Portugal have never medaled at the World Champs. So this is absolutely huge for them to be this close. France have finished second twice, 1948 and 1997. They've finished third place 9 times, most recently in 2022. Love how the LeBrons always do a little victory lap.
It's like they have so much energy, they just got to get some of it out.
They got to get out. Good start here for Marcos Freitas, the left-hander.
We saw how smooth the tournament has been for both sides. This might be the first heavy test, the big test.
A lot of frenetic energy around Alexis Lebrun. Well, there was too much height on that. And only one thing that Freitas was going to do. That's an excellent start so far.
Just going to put it away. Love that inside out forehand.
Oh, he's playing well, isn't he?
Really is. Marcos Freitas knows that he has the work to do. In fact, this is a team where he is really the number one. And he's expected or hoped to take 2 points.
Yeah, let him take the points and then worry about the main man, Felix. Well, you play Felix later.
Marcos Freitas looks like he's a bit cold. He keeps breathing on his hands and rubbing them together.
Well, I can tell you, I put on my thick coat about an hour and a half ago. It did get a little cold in here. This is normal weather for Barbara, not so much for the rest of us normal people.
Living in Chicago has really hardened me.
He was trying to counter, wasn't he?
He was.
Alexi.
Alexi Lebrun looking unfazed by this opening game, as if saying, I'm just warming up.
2-6.
That is second point. Well, Alexis Lebrun started his World Champs with a win over Tobias Rasmussen. 3-0 over Denmark. Marcos Freitas taking his time here a little bit. Just the comeback trail is pretty good. Excellent work from Alexi.
I feel like Alexi Lebrun is just getting started.
Yeah.
Like the first 10 or so points of this match were just warm up.
It wasn't quite ready. Yeah, one thing you'll notice that the Lebruns love to just move very, very fast between points.
That's the pace that they love to play at. So they have that energy, that excitement, they need to get it out.
Five points in a row.
But it seems like in the beginning, Alexi unfazed. Because he said, I'm just getting started, just warming up.
Yeah, and he's now gotten to a groove, hasn't he?
I wouldn't mind, I don't mind your 6-1 lead.
Yeah, it's unfazed him. And he's taken the lead here fantastically well, Alexis Lebrun. On the Chiquita, beautifully done down the line. All of a sudden, it's become just about Alexis Lebrun.
It's the Alexis Lebrun show.
Yeah.
He was down 1-6. Now he's up 9-7.
Leg 9-7.
And he's got game points in hand. This is tremendous from Alexis Lebrun.
And this game is progressing so quickly.
It is. That's exactly what he wants. Well, his second match against Algeria, he won against Mehdi Boulousa, 3-0, Alexis Lebrun. Then played against Robert Gardosh of Austria, won 3-0. Rested against France. Sorry, against... Australia, had a bit of a break. So Marcus Freitas saved another game point. Well, yesterday they played Poland, France did. 10-all here, brilliant. Three in a row from Marcus Freitas when it matters most. And Alexis Lebrun beat Jakob Deas 3-2. That was a close one, 11-8 in the last game. 4 points in a row for Freitas. And he's got game point.
He's seeming pumped about it.
Well, the tables have turned again. Three big momentum shifts in this first game. What a backhand that was. Yep, I'm going to go at my pace, thank you. Well within his right to do that.
Very much so.
And it also just then, I guess, puts Alexi off his rhythm, right?
Mm-hmm. Alexi trying to force the rhythm.
Yeah.
Marcus Freitas says, no, no, no.
You wait for me.
Yeah.
And I guess that's a good way to go about it, right?
Yeah, I mean, you have to.
Yeah.
You have to, because you have to respect your own boundaries for what you're able, what you want to play.
Game point here for Marcus Freitas.
I think that serve was just not exactly what he wanted. Felt a little bit long, a little bit loose. Wow.
An even bigger lap of honor there for Alexis Lebrun.
The energy, just explosive. Great attack right into the middle, but it was really the serve that helped him get there.
Game point here for Lebrun. Oh, what a way for that to happen. Oh dear, that is hugely disappointing for Marcos Freitas.
And I feel like we've seen a lot of missed serves on table one.
Today, especially.
In the critical
moments. Yeah. Is that the pressure? He won 3-0.
Second game.
And in his final match against Thailand in the group stages, he was arrested. Brought back against Croatia. He played Andre Gricina, won 3-0, and then he needed to play against Filip Zeljko, and he won 3-0. So he's kind of got better as the event has progressed. But he won't be too fazed by losing the first game necessarily, as we've seen so far.
Right.
So this is a much higher level player.
Unfazed, but annoyed by the fashion.
Yeah, by the how, yeah, correct.
One, all.
Also, when we go back to the lead he had as well, when you lead by 5 or 6 points and you don't go on to win, that's got to hurt.
It does hurt. Although he knows Alexei Lebrun is a formidable opponent.
Truth. That's an unusual serve.
One, two.
Adam Bovra calls it the lollipop serve, windshield wiper. A great piece of variation.
Yeah.
Really fun to do as well.
Nothing else that puts off your opponent. Great stuff there from Freitas.
Right over the table. He stayed close to the table. Look at that positioning.
Two great forehands from Freitas.
And it's Freitas who's using that lefty advantage to send it very wide out into the wide forehand right there. It's very difficult for righties to return because the ball curves away from you. You can see Alexei Lebrun just not getting to the ball.
Here we go again.
Two, four.
Well, he's going to keep doing that, especially if it's going to put off his opponent. Why not?
Three, four.
Seems that Alexei Lebrun is not put off by it, actually.
No, to be fair to him, he's actually just getting on with it, isn't he? Okay, well, it seems to be getting to Marcos Freitas a bit more.
Yeah.
And he's right, I'm not obliged to follow it.
And he is absolutely correct. He's not delaying the game.
No, but it was Alexei Lebrun under his breath. You're watching. You're watching. He wanted to kind of, he wants to get under his skin. Mm-hmm. That's also part of the rushing things, isn't it?
Yes, yes. There's a lot of games being played that are not on the table.
Right.
Six, three.
Now, this will be a close contest. They both know they're going to use everything they can to win.
But by the way, Alexei Lebrun's winning percentage against left-handers is actually more than his overall winning percentage, 64%. He's won 14 out of 22. So he's not too fussed about playing lefties. Come back again from Lebrun.
Seven, five.
You know, it's a little bit hard for me to see who really has the edge.
There's not much between them, right?
Yeah, it's very close. No one seems to be dominating the serve, or dominating the attack, or dominating the rally.
Right.
Really flipping back and forth.
seven, six.
You know,
misses that one.
It feels like these two are playing mind games, whereas in the previous match, there was actually a clear tactical strategy.
So there's as much going on off the table as there is on it. Two-point lead for Marcos Freitas.
And a different kind of energy from Alexi Lebrun. No more of those running laps.
That's true. That's a very good point. He's stopped that. I wonder. Does that mean he's kind of more settled?
I think so.
That
more
excess
serious.
Energy, yeah.
Shaking off that adrenaline from walking on.
Also wonders because he's not on the French corner. Oh, wonderful loops and counter loops.
Tremendous positioning. And look at that spin. Also the athleticism.
Still fighting here, Lebrun. Yeah, it's amazing how these two brothers have come out of nowhere, really, in the last couple of years.
Taking
just the time for the Olympics, right?
Yeah, taking the world by storm.
Yeah.
French becoming a superpower in table
tennis.
They
have two game points here. Marcos Freitas, again, not going to be fazed by this. Alexi Lebrun, there's a brother, Felix. One saved. Remember the last game went on for a bit?
It did. Critical moment.
He saved it again.
And the laps.
And the laps are back.
Alexi Lebrun needs this big court.
Yeah. And would you believe it? That's three in a row. He's got a game point.
I'm out.
Timeout call by Portugal.
It is critically important that they win 10-8.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's a good point.
But maybe they weren't so worried back then.
At that point, yeah.
Or 10-10 even, but now.
They're putting a lot, that means they're showing a lot of weight on this particular game.
Yes.
Oh, that was a chance there, wasn't it?
If Alexi Lebrun went up 2-0, that was a big mountain to climb. You lose your momentum.
Yeah.
But if it's 1-1, you're just right in it.
11-all now. Marcos Freitas now has a game point. It's yielded some benefits here that timeout. Alexi, it's his third game point, by the way. And he survived all three of them.
Tournament tough, match tough. Yeah,
he just, nothing really seems to bother him.
I've seen it all. Yeah. I beat Fenton on an edge.
There you go.
This is nothing.
Yeah, exactly. Again, he's in front here, Marcos Freitas, his fourth game point.
Nice reverse pendulum serve, great opening attack.
He's in trouble here, and Marcos Freitas finally takes this game.
And that timeout was worth it.
Yeah, really big.
Yeah, great block. That's what changed the momentum of the point. Able to hit it so wide.
I mean, they're both working really hard. Look how close these games have been so far. Really nothing between them. But what I'm enjoying, Barbara, is the kind of dramatics that are going around the points.
So dramatic. Wait. Lexi Russ says, no problem, I'll throw it straight up.
One, all.
Marcos Freitas, this forehand, cross court, if he can hit it very wide into Lexi's forehand, that has been working.
Brilliant on the forehand there from LeBron.
For any loop that is just not perfectly powerful, well placed.
Down the line. Sorry, Barbara.
Alexi LeBron would just put it away.
Yeah, lovely. He's quite happy to play in that forehand, isn't he, Freitas?
Yes, this is what he's using.
Yeah. It's easy for him to put away, Freitas. Leading by three.
Looking at the lineup and considering their past head-to-head, they're looking for Freitas to take this to Portugal.
Absolutely right.
That's part of the strategy.
You'd have to say that both Felix LeBron and Simon Gauzy should be the favored player in their respective matches. Marcos Freitas has been a busy player this year already, played the star contender at Goa, the Europe Top 16 Cup, and the WTT star contender in Doha. So far this year, three events played, six matches played, three wins, three losses. From Alexi LeBron.
Wow. Just so quick. Alexi LeBron stays close to the table. Even with that big counter loop just down the line, world class. I mean, he is world class. So just an amazing shot.
Three, six.
Being pretty happy with his win over Dang Cho of Germany in the quarterfinals of the Europe Top 16. One of the quarterfinals at 4-2. For Alexi LeBron.
Again,
so powerful.
When I see Alexi LeBron do those laps, it's like he's pumped, he's ready, he's correct. Playing well.
Thank you.
great placement by Freitas, kind of into the middle. Freitas just loving his forehand. That is his game. He reminds me a bit of Timo Boll, actually.
Mm. Yeah. Alexis Lebrun has also played 6 matches this year, 1-3 and lost 3. Also, the star contender in Goa and the Europe top 16 in Montreux, as well as star contender in Doha. I'll tell you what will be satisfying. He beat his brother in the quarterfinals of the Europe top 16.
I wonder what it's like at family dinners.
Yeah, that'll be fun.
And their father is the coach.
When you beat your higher ranked brother, that has got to feel good.
But also your baby brother.
Correct.
8-7.
Time to bring out the big shots, end game.
Shut up! 7-9.
You can see the Portuguese bench. They're like almost jumping over the barrier.
Yeah. They're feeling it now. 2 up here.
8-9.
It's difficult for Marcus Freitas to block something from Alexis Lebrun. Got to make some tricky moves in the beginning.
8-9. Shut up! 10-8.
So game points here. Two game points for Marcos Freitas. One saved again. I mean, this is like a carbon copy of the last game, isn't it?
It is. I mean, it just shows how close they are. No one can really pull ahead. It's difficult to win the game, even if you have game points. Backhand, and that's what Marcus Freitas needs to do. How creative.
Wow, again, it's a very tight game here with Marcus Freitas winning it. It's the first one we've had.
Fourth game, Portugal.
Well, he's sitting down, and he's not out yet either, that young man.
Alexis Lebrun says he plays the best when he's having fun, and we can really see that here.
Yeah, he is. France are down at the moment.
In that same interview, he says he really, really hates losing.
Yeah, you get the impression with both Lebruns that they can't stand it. Huge competitors.
One love. Hey, come on, hey. Come on. One, two.
Good work here from Freitas. Yeah, it was immediately retreating.
Yeah, he knew it. That was going to come like a bullet.
Bright start here for Marcos Freitas. And a timeout call by France.
Under pressure.
Have been runners up twice and third place four times. So the last time they even got a bronze was 1953. The last time they were runners up was 1997. So this should be a big moment for them as well. Both these teams exited at the quarterfinal stage 2 years ago in Chengdu.
Someone will be making history today.
Exactly.
I think for the French team, I mean, they're looking to obviously medal here because they're setting themselves up for Paris 2024.
Yeah. Correct.
First pendulum serve has been working very well.
Yeah. I just wonder sometimes, you know, he's got... he loves to attack. He loves to be on the front foot, Lebrun. Sometimes you feel that because he snatches at it, he goes for it too quickly. Wants to play his shots. Trailing by three here. Now four, he's in trouble. Marcos Freitas wins this. And it gives Portugal the lead.
He's done his job if he can pull this off.
Six of the last eight now going Marcos Freitas' way.
Were you saying that perhaps Alexis Lebrun sometimes can swing too much? There's so much adrenaline.
Yeah.
It's like
just
pumping.
Wonder whether that puts too much pressure on his shots. He's kind of losing his way here, isn't he? This has been the most one-sided of games thus far, though we know he has staged comebacks of this nature before. Trails by five here.
Five, nine.
There you go, really attack that.
I feel that Marcos Freitas probably has this in the bag, just the body language from Alexis Lebrun.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah. Five game points now for Freitas.
If you want to come back from this level, you have to really try it. I don't see that here yet.
Six.
Still four game points. Match point, excuse me.
That reverse pendulum.
Leg, ten, six.
Looking for Alexi to make that flip or to miss it outright. I think that's the goal.
So Marcos Freitas continues his perfect record against Alexis Lebrun. That was the biggest margin of victory in all the games. And he beats Alexis LeBrun 12-14, 14-12, 11-9, 11-6. It got better as things progressed.